Hello everyone, welcome back to my YouTube channel. If you're new here, my name's Emily and thank you so much for joining me today. For today's video, we're gonna be doing my skincare favorites. And I'm so excited to show you guys everything that I've discovered, especially over the past year or so. I've really found what works best for me. I'm gonna show you guys my favorite bath and body products, skincare, face products, as well as hair products. So stay tuned. Now, when it comes to hair products, that's what I'd like to start off with. If you guys have been following me on Instagram for a while, you'll know that back in the day, a couple years ago, I went through a phase where I dyed my hair like every shade of purplish, bluish, silver, pink, whatever that I possibly could. I can throw in a couple images for you guys to reference. First, I want to tell you guys how I got my hair back to this color, this nice kind of gray toned silvery blonde. So my hair, this is really my favorite hair color that I've ever had. This is kind of my go-to. It doesn't matter if I dye my hair whatever rainbow color, I feel like I always come back to this shade because I think it works best for me. It speaks to me. I want to be this little fairy princess with like white silvery blonde hair. That's just always what I've loved, and I'm super happy with where my hair is at right now. So I'm gonna show you guys the different products I use to really get this color. Now, if you've tried to get this color in the past and you've struggled with it, I completely can empathize with you on that one. This is definitely not an easy hairstyle to maintain or to achieve. It requires, first of all, a lot of bleach, and definitely don't do that yourself. I've tried that. I'll touch up my roots now and then, but bleaching your whole head, definitely go to professionals first. They can really help you kind of get this look. So here we go, let's get into hair products first. So starting off with shampoo and conditioner. My recent favorites that I've discovered that I absolutely love are these Love Beauty and Planet shampoo and conditioners. Now, these are sulfate free. Well, I have two different ones here actually. I ran out of the conditioner of one and got a different scent because, I don't know, something about these, they smell amazing. I mean, if nothing else, these just smell fabulous. But they're also really good for your hair, and they make my hair feel better than it's felt in a very long time. I have, for the shampoo, I have the turmeric and tonka essence one, which I feel like is great if you don't want something that smells super girly. I know that when my fiance comes to stay with me, I like to kind of make sure that I have shampoos and conditioners that aren't super girly so that he can use them too and doesn't feel like, you know, he smells like a girl. So this one, oh, I love it. It's got kind of a really nice musky, spicy smell to it. It's absolutely fabulous. This is one of my favorites, the turmeric and tonka essence one. And then I tried out a new scent for the conditioner this time around, and I got the Hope and Repair conditioner. This one's meant for damaged hair, which is great for me because with all the bleaching, my hair definitely does get damaged, and I like to keep it hydrated with this. This is the coconut oil and Lang Lang. I think that's how you say it. It's got the Y. It's like Ylang Ylang, but I think it's Lang Lang, I'm pretty sure. This smells fabulous. This is a little bit more of a feminine scent, but I couldn't resist. I had to get this one. I think it just smells absolutely amazing, very classic. Love these great shampoos and conditioners. Now, when it comes to hair products, I definitely have to make sure that I use a silver shampoo or a silver conditioner. I've tried many, many of these in the past in order to get this kind of silvery blonde look, because with this kind of hairstyle, you really have to make sure that you tone out the yellowness of the platinum blonde. Here, I'm gonna show you guys, this is a recent discovery that I've made. This is the Caracolor color and conditioner, silver conditioner. I believe they have a shampoo too, which I actually do want to get. I just grab the conditioner first. Sometimes I'll actually condition twice. I'll use like this one and then I'll use this after. Now, what I really love about this product is actually just that it's not a purple toned shampoo or conditioner. Well, it is slightly. It's more of like a grayish color. What I found in the past is that These typically weren't as potent as the purple ones that I was using. I would find that the purple shampoos and conditioners would kind of get this color better, but if I overused them, it would leave a purple tint to my hair, which I really didn't want. And up until I found this product, I hadn't found one of these grayish colored ones that really actually was potent enough to make my hair gray, which is why I was so impressed with this. It's actually the color that it makes your hair. It doesn't just turn it purple, it actually makes it gray, which is really cool. I've used it a couple times so far, and as you can see on the back, this shows kind of the progression of after each wash what it gets to, or after each couple washes. I'm somewhere in the middle of these two right now, since I did just get this product about a week ago, so I'm still kind of gauging my reaction to it, but first impressions is that it's working really well. You can see here my hair is not yellowy whatsoever. It's kind of in between these two, and I'm really excited to see the progression as it gets a little darker. I think that it'll be fun to kind of rock more of a grayish look, which is what I think this is gonna give me. So we'll see on this one. I'll get back to you guys, but so far I really like this product. Moving on to more hair products, one of my favorite universal body hair whatever products ever is coconut oil. I have literally like 4 jars of this all over my apartment. I use it on my body to moisturize my skin. I love to use it after I shave, and this is also awesome for making a hair mask, especially if you bleach your hair as much as I do. This is really great to do even just once a month to kind of refresh your hair. Now, after I wash my hair, what I like to do is put in like a detangling spray as well as like a hair oil to make my hair nice and soft so that it's easy to brush out. I really love this Argan Oil of Morocco Healing Dry Oil by OGX. You can get this just at Target, Walmart, whatever. Very easy product to find. I just use a little of this, just a couple of sprays go a long way, because it will make your hair a little greasy if you use too much, but it's really nice to give you that shine and that nice healthy feeling to your hair. Additionally with that, I like to use this Pantene heat spray. Really, I found a bunch of different heat sprays that I like. This one I think smells great, and it also works well for detangling my hair when it's wet. As far as volumizing my hair, what I love to use is this Bedhead Small Talk, and I really love this stuff because if you're like me, if you bleach your hair a lot, then sometimes you'll find that it thins out a little bit. And this stuff is really great to kind of thicken your hair up and give it that nice luscious feel again. Now, moving on to some of my favorite body products. For in the shower, what I really love to use is, honestly, I found this line. This is from Bath & Body Works. It's the Into the Night scent. I think this was like a New Year's release. I think they still have it. This stuff, oh my God. Smells amazing. I have like all of the products in this line. Absolutely love it. Probably my favorite would be the moisturizing body wash. Really, all of Bath & Body Works line of the moisturizing body washes are awesome because it makes your skin feel nice, especially if you live in a drier climate. It's really great to have products like this that moisturize your body as well as kind of being a body wash, especially when I'm up north at my parents' house. I find that my skin dries out a lot more easily than when I'm down south in the humidity, so I really love to use these for when I'm in that type of climate. Again, with the Into the Night scent, I need to open this and smell it right now because it makes me so happy every time. The stuff, so amazing, so amazing. This is actually the Whipped Glotion, and I love these. If you're like me, then being glowy, covered in glitter all the time is always okay. That's what's awesome about this product, is it actually has little flecks of sparkle in it and glitter, and it just makes your skin so pretty. I really love to use it after I will put on self-tanner. It just adds that really nice kind of sparkly, glowy effect to my already tanned skin. So this stuff is awesome if you want to be a sparkly, glowing goddess. This is for you. Now, I do have some more favorites from Bath & Body Works, and those are actually going to be the aromatherapy line. I absolutely love these. First of all, the scents are just timeless. They're amazing. Probably my favorite would be the happiness one here. I think, I don't know, maybe it's just all in my head, but whenever I put this on, it makes me feel happy. I don't know. It does something. I have the energy one as well, which is really fabulous. The passion one, which I'm almost out of, this is actually a body wash. These two are the lotions. And I just think the bottles are really pretty too. I love to put these like by my sink right next to the hand soap so I can use them after I wash my hands. These are awesome. And I think that they did an absolutely amazing job creating scents that really evoke a feeling when you use them. For more bath kind of products, I have to show you guys these shave gels. These are the EOS Evolution of Smooth Shave Creams. These are awesome. They moisturize your skin while you're shaving, which is really nice because you don't want your skin to feel super irritated. And I find that these are gentle enough and really fabulous for just making your skin feel awesome after you shave. They make it really easy and they smell great too. Now, I did mention self-tanning a minute ago. I am an avid lover of some self-tan. During summertime, I do like to have a bit of a tan. And I'm kind of more on the fair skin side, so I don't really love to lay out because I get burnt. I don't want to have sun damage to my skin, really. I don't use tanning beds or anything. I really just use self-tanner to kind of keep that glow. So some of my favorite products for that, this is the Ulta Self-Tanning Foam. It's the Bronze Glow Ultra Dark Express Tan Tinted Mousse. This is a 1 hour express tan infused with coconut water. And as you guys can see here, this is kind of the color evolution at the bottom here. Honestly, if you've used Loving Tan in the past, which I have, I used to be a super huge fan of Loving Tan, but it's kind of expensive. And I wanted to find a good dupe for that, which this is totally 100%. A fabulous dupe for the Loving Tan Mousse. It's pretty much the exact same product, just the Ulta brand. It's only 10 bucks and it does exactly the same thing, lasts just as long. I find that I don't get any weird spots or anything when it starts to fade. I typically will put this on at night before I go to bed, and then I'll actually put on just some old like leggings and a t-shirt I don't care about in case it kind of rubs off on my clothes a little in my sleep. And I'll sleep in this and then just shower it off in the morning. I know it only says 1 hour, so you can use it on the go. If you know you're about to go out, you wanna get a quick tan, you can put it on, rinse it off in an hour, and you're good. For me, I just like to go the extra mile and I'll just leave it on all night to make sure it really does its job and then just wash it off in the morning. To maintain my self-tan in between when I use this, I'll typically use this every other week. I like to use the Jergens, this is the Natural Glow Self-Tanning Lotion, and what's great about this is it's a gradual self-tanner, and I find that it really kind of helps to maintain this in between uses. Now, moving on to face products. This is probably my favorite part of the video because I have some really good stuff to show you guys here. So, we're gonna start off with makeup removing products. I typically prefer to use wipes, but recently I've actually tried using like an oil removing balm, which I like as well. I'm gonna show you guys first my favorite wipes. These are the Neutrogena makeup removing wipes. They're super popular because they're so freaking awesome. They work really, really well. If I just want to take my makeup off really quick and just not worry about it, I know that these wipes are great. We'll get everything off. For an oil removing balm, this one I recently tried is the Pharmacy Beauty Very Cherry Clean. This stuff I typically like to use if I have a lot of heavy makeup on because sometimes I need a little extra help making sure I get everything off. For cleansing after I get all my makeup removed, I've recently discovered this product, actually this brand. This cleanser here is like a foaming cleanser and it just makes you feel so clean. I feel like if I sometimes don't think that I got everything off with either of these, I know that this will definitely remove whatever residue is left over. Furthermore, after that, sometimes I'll also use a micellar cleansing water. This one from Tarte is really awesome. First of all, the packaging is just so cool. I absolutely love this. And it just has a little pump top. You can use like a little cotton ball, cotton pad on it. And this is perfect. I also love to use this in the morning sometimes. I'll wash my face, and then this just has such a nice refreshing feel that I'll put this on after, and it just makes me feel really refreshed and ready to start my day. So I have some masks and some different face oils and moisturizers that I'm gonna show you guys. Love just like taking that time for myself at the end of the night to spend on my skincare. Super fun for me, and masks are probably my favorite part of that. I'm gonna show you guys this one here. I actually got this in St. Augustine on my senior class field trip. Here, as you can see, it comes in a very fancy box. Very fancy. I kept all the packaging and everything because I spent so much on this. This is actually the Rock Crystal Instant Skin Polisher from Crystals Cosmetics, and that's Crystals with a K. This is a product that was an investment for me, but it's certainly paid off. Basically, we were in St. Augustine, which was super awesome. We had an absolutely fabulous time there. So we had a time where everyone kind of got to break off and go shopping downtown at the little downtown area. The three of us, oh my goodness, we just had a time in this Crystals Cosmetics store. The people that worked there were great salespeople, talked all three of us into getting all these super expensive beauty products, because of course at the time we had acne, we had problems, and we were in this super bougie cosmetics store, and these people were being so nice to us. That's literally why we spent money in there, is because we were just having such a fun time talking to all the employees. They did all these cool demonstrations with this product here. They tested it out just like on our arms. It was like magic before your eyes. It doesn't even really smell like much. It just looks like this clear jelly stuff. You put it on and you rub it into your skin. You just use a little amount. You just want a really thin layer, leave it on for about a minute, and then you rub it off. It actually exfoliates your skin. The clear particles, everything you could see, it changed color, and it turned, you could see all the dirt that it was absorbing, and as you rubbed it off, there were just like flakes of like dead skin and dirt and everything that came off. It was kind of gross, but kind of awesome at the same time. It completely got rid of all the dirt, all the dead skin. So this stuff was really, really amazing. You could literally see it working. Even just testing it on an arm, you could see the most noticeable difference. This product is fabulous, and I'm gonna continue to use it till it's gone. It comes with, it's got, again, this fancy little spatula things. It even comes with like this bougie little card. You know how like if you get a handbag or something and it comes with the authentication and everything, like, yeah, certificate of authenticity. Like, how bougie is this? So fancy, but well worth the money. Moving on from that, that's a mask that I use for exfoliating. One that I love for moisturizing is actually this Glam Glow Berry Glow Probiotic Recovery Mask. This is such a bizarre yet intriguing product. It honestly looks like yogurt. It really does. It's very weird, kind of like gelatinous, kind of funky, and this product is awesome. I love to use this. Every few days I'll put this on and just leave it on for like 45 minutes or however long I feel like. And what's awesome about this isn't a mask that you have to completely wash all off your face like how this one is. And it says, apply an even layer to clean skin. Leave on for 10 minutes. For best results, tissue off smoothly any excess. This product is great. It makes my skin feel so beautiful and nice and moisturized. I love it. It's awesome. After I do a mask, I like to use a face oil. One of my favorites from the brand Elemis that I was just talking about a minute ago is the Pro Collagen Rose Facial Oil. This stuff, if you like the scent of rose, this is for you. It just makes me feel so luxurious and nice when I put it on. I love to put it all over my face and on my neck and kind of my chest area. It's just a rose oil, so you can really kind of use it wherever you want. For my last product, this is my Holy Grail product. It's so unexpected. I'm sure you guys have probably seen it on the shelves at Target or Walmart or whatever grocery store you go to, but this stuff right here, Cetaphil. This is literally just a, it says body lotion, but I use it on my face. I use it everywhere, but mainly on my face. I think using less products and sticking to one product, this right here, has really helped my skin so much, contains 9 moisturizers and vitamins E and B5. And I found that this works better than literally any moisturizer that I've ever tried in my entire life. It's great to use moisturizing your face before you put on makeup. I use it every day as like a primer. It actually has glycerin as the second ingredient, which glycerin helps your makeup to stay on. It kind of creates a little bit of a tacky base, and it makes your makeup go on beautifully. It keeps it on all day, and it also keeps your skin hydrated too. This stuff is the best. And that brings us to the end of this video, you guys. I hope you found this super helpful. Again, it's different for everybody. Really, you just have to find what works best for you. I'm happy to say that over the years, I've discovered what works best for me. So I was really glad to share it all with you guys. Yeah, I'm really excited for what's to come. You guys, stay tuned. I'll have more videos coming. I'm trying to get more consistent with uploading, but I'm having a lot of fun on this YouTube journey. And thank you guys so much for watching and subscribing. Please feel free to follow me on Instagram for more fashion content. Thank you so much, guys, for staying tuned, and I will see you on the next one. Bye!